May is Blackfly month in the Adirondacks. But with good planning and a little luck, it's also a great month to get out for backcountry camping. Ideally, you'll want a few cool, windy days, and it helps to camp near a big lake. Heading down Little Tupper Lake to Rock Pond from the 7th to the 10th fit the bill. Overnight temperatures were in the 30s, and it was windy much of the time. So my friends and family always want to know, how were the blackflies? They're good, I say. They wish you'd stop by. They miss you. Little Tupper Lake sees a lot of views. I can't say that it's crowded, but you'll see other campers, and the most popular sites are frequently taken. Rock Pond is a little harder to reach. Just hard enough, it seems, so that the usage is far less. You can expect a wilderness camping experience at Rock Pond most of the time. And Hardigan Pond, with Little Salmon Lake and Lily Pad Pond nearby, sees very little use. A few hardy groups pass through each year on the Little Tupper to Lake Lila paddling traverse, but that's a daunting trip, and few try it. The 2-mile carry from Rock Pond to Hardigan is a big part of that difficulty. It's messy even as a day hike if you're camping at Rock Pond. The cluster of ponds in the southwestern corner of the Whitney Wilderness are remote and wild, and that's the best reason to go there.